Let me ask you a question. Do you follow the Bible or anything like that? You go to church, you Christian? The Bible says, the Bible, will a man rob God? The answer is yes. Well, you have robbed me.
I know what people think, but what people think is just an opinion. So 9 times out of 10, what you saying or thinking is wrong. My partner used to say, the only people that know what happened is the dead person and the nigga that shot him. Everybody else just saw somebody get shot. But what happened? How did they end up here? Start from the beginning. The beginning of the end. Jail, everybody has a story about how much money they made, cars they had, or the woman. Yeah, that stuff is nice, but there's nothing more entertaining than what actually happened. That's why they have all these biopics and reality TV shows. People want to know what really happened. Well, I'm Ari. Most people call me A. So you could call me A. From Harlem. Uptown. But a few years ago, I got a job, so I moved to Westchester County. And I only come around when I need to.
Yo, what's up?
Yo, what up, boy? You good?
Yeah, I'm good.
What's up, you alright?
My mom. Foot broke. She can't work at the supermarket no more. My brother just got locked up.
Oh, your mother ain't get a lawyer yet?
Yeah, she did, but I need to take care of my family. Let me work for you. Come on.
I know this shit is real out here. Ain't no games. Open that glove compartment.
Watch this. You still got some bit. Hit me up.
Oh! See the rich rule over the poor, and the borrower serving to the lender.
Oh, he got money!
And that motherfucker owe me money.
Who?
Dude over there rolling the dice.
Yo, V, what's up? What you got, man? Fat boys. Oh, word? Nah, what you got? Alright, so five.
Handle that.
You want me to shoot him?
Nah. I want you to kill him.
4, 5, 6, right here. 4, 5, 6, right
here. You know what you're doing, right?
Right here.
Fucking gun. I
pulled
the trigger.
Oh!
What's up? Where money at? Hey, yo, man, double up, nigga.
Oh, what you talking about?
That's spicy. Woo! He got money! Oh, shit, he got money today, all right? That's what I'm talking about. He got money. I ain't gotta look at it. What's up?
Yo, what's up?
Yo, what up, boy? You good?
Yeah, I'm good. Let me work for you. Come on.
Open that glove compartment.
What you want me to do with that?
Just chill. I got you. See the ritual over the pole? And the bar was serving to the lender. And that motherfucker owe me money.
4, 5, 6, right here. You want me to shoot?
Right here, right here. Nah. I want you to kill him.
This fucking gun. Come here. Come here. Come here. Don't you ever listen to this motherfucker. Do you hear me? Do you hear me? Shake your head if you fucking hear me.
What the fuck was that?
I almost killed that little motherfucker.
Come here.
Get the fuck off me, eh? Get the fuck off me. You come around here with some other people for some stupid shit like that.
You should have seen your face, though.
Come on.
You should have seen your face, yo.
Come on,
man. Stop crying, man. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Hurry up.
Give me a goddamn heart attack.
So, I come to you to ask for help, to tell you what I'm going through. And all this, you think it's a joke?
It's a lesson in this. I mean, you didn't even think about shit. You didn't even check the gun. It's fucking broad daylight out here. These niggas in the middle of a dice game in the hood. And you walking up attempting to shoot somebody? You didn't think this is wrong, huh? You didn't think about your family? This game, gotta think before you do anything. Anything. So pay the bills, buy yourself something, and get a fucking haircut or something, man. Yo, what the fuck you want?
I'm going to get a cab.
Hey, man, your ass better be in school tomorrow.
Who the fuck is that?
It's my ex. It's her son. Think he cut out for this shit.
What, you got the little nigga in train?
Nah, I'm trying to keep him out of it. Are you almost done with that?
Yeah. I was trying to call you and tell you we lost 40 off the last joint you gave us. We didn't want to have nothing when you came back, so we got rid of it anyway.
Sorry. I got some more in the trunk. You got something we can cook?
Yeah, just walk the car. Come upstairs.
Alright.
Yeah.
I'll do that.
Alright.
Yo, you alright?
I'm alright. You good? That's me. Kaz. Short for Cosmic. And me and Ari been homies so long, I can't even remember how we met. Diapers or some shit.
What's up, you know me?
No, but I wouldn't mind getting to know you.
I'm Brian. What's your name?
Sheikah. Let me give you my number.
I'll call you in a minute, all right?
Okay.
Why the fuck do you have clothes on?
Nigga, do you bugging?
I'm funny.
Yeah, you're a joke.
Spot check.
Not in front of all these niggas.
Bitch, get the fuck up and go in the bathroom. Take your clothes off. Take your clothes off now. Get the fuck up. Get up. Go to the bathroom.
Fuck you, you fat motherfucker. I fucking hate you.
Yo.
Who the fuck does that bitch think she's talking to?
Yo.
You need to go in there and set that bitch straight. You need to kill.
Cass.
What?
Wait a minute. Handle that, man.
Bitch, you stealing
from me? Nigga, I don't
gotta steal. Ow! Shut the fuck up! Shut up! Shut up! All right,
shorty.
Damn, look at that shit. That's 15 off, right? That ain't good.
Mm-hmm. It's all right, though. I'll fix it.
So this ain't 60-40, all right?
All right. Yo. Yo. Come here. Come here!
It's a lesson in this. I mean, you didn't even think about shit. You didn't even check the gun. It's fucking broad daylight out here. These niggas in the middle of a dice game in the hood. And you walking up attempting to shoot somebody?
Who the fuck is that?
It's my ex. It's her son.
Get the fuck up. Get up. Go to bed.
Fuck you, you fat motherfucker. I fucking hate you.
Yo, what the fuck is this?
I was gonna tell you about that.
What? Why you ain't called me?
I called you 15 times yesterday. You ain't never see a phone.
Yo, so why you ain't text me, bro?
Niggas don't text on these flip phones. What the fuck you want me to do?
Yo. How long you been?
3 days.
Yo, why is it so cold in here?
I called and it said to make the room as cold as possible to eliminate the smell.
What?
Make the room as cold as possible to eliminate the smell.
So now you Dr. Oz and shit?
No, I'm not Dr. Oz.
Yo. Wrap them up, I'll take care of it, alright?
How?
Yo, I don't know, but they can't stay here.
Alright. Alright.
Now, I'm gonna tell you a story. And it's not gonna start with once upon a time, and it's not gonna have a happy fucking ending. Today's cash crop is the synthetic drugs. Mollies. Bath salts, opioids, LSD, K2, all the man-made shit. Right now, me and Ari are just two greedy-ass crack dealers living what's left of that life. The times, they had changed. Niggas like us wasn't driving Bentleys no more. Not like back in the Nino Brown days, when every dude in the hood was making 100 G's a night. Nowadays, coke gets stepped on so hard, by the time we get it and cook it down in the rock, we lost 30% of the weight. 30%. But like them church folk always say, when God shuts one door, He opens up another. That's Buddha, Mount Vernon's most prominent and successful narcotics dealer. In that pile of red dust, that's Buddha's own custom blend of dope. Best damn shit the streets ever seen. Got niggas lined up to buy that shit like lotto tickets.
This is the latest batch. Could be exactly what we need to get us back to those Nino Brown days.
Tell me what that's about.
Problem is, me, Ari, and Buddha, we don't know each other. Yeah.
This right here, this is what you call a fiend. A demon or an unclean spirit. But in the projects, a fiend ain't nothing but a damn junkie. A fiend gets possessed by a force far more powerful than anything on earth. Driving them forth. Propelling them towards that one sole objective. Making it feel like the first time. That shit ain't never happening again. You a virgin once, and only once. All you doing now is chasing a ghost.
521.
Spanky, Spanky. The last time we seen each other, she was like 15, right? You know, ain't no Jovi this time. Yeah, you going up with the big boys. doing with this? What the fuck is this?
That ain't mine, I'm telling you.
You seen your car?
Somebody left it there, I'm telling you.
Nigga, who you protecting?
It don't even matter.
Wait, I know him.
What?
I know him.
Who, him?
Yeah, yes, I know him. That's Buddha.
Yeah, and?
I live with him.
Drug dealers, they're accused of being drug suppliers. The fentanyl and heroin that was found inside of this house has a street value worth $6.5 million. Investigators say this is some of the evidence found inside. Drugs stashed away in furniture. There was even equipment there to make pills. In all, 5 kilograms of fentanyl and 6 kilograms of heroin were seized. According to the DEA, the fentanyl alone had the potency to kill over 2 million people.
To explain this, or you want me to explain it?
They looking at it.
Okay, Porky.
Yeah.
We listening.
Yo, watch him out.
You acting like I said something wrong.
I'm a cop. Always wanted to be one. And Kaz almost fought when he found out I was in the academy. But the good thing about all this is, I work in the same town Buddha hustles in.
Well, what the fucking do, Wilbur?
Good morning. Subject is Ronnie Jackson, a.k.a. Buddha. Buddha runs a drug gang called DMM. That stands for Drugs, Money, and Murder. Apparently, they've been distributing large amounts of narcotics and guns into Mount Vernon. Today is Judgment Day. As I said, Buddha has a long rap sheet. We don't know what we're walking into. Pray, meditate, whatever your religious beliefs are. Let's just make it back here in one piece.
The end.
What's your name?
Chica. Let me give you my number.
Yo, what the fuck is this? Wrap him up. I'll take care of it, all right?
Today's cash crop is the synthetic drugs. Right now, me and Ari are just two greedy-ass crack dealers.
Wait. I know him.
What?
I know him. That's Buddha.
Yeah? And?
I live with him.
And that pile of red dust? That's Buddha's own custom blend of dope. Best damn shit the streets ever seen.
The fentanyl and heroin that was found inside of this house has a street value worth $6.5 million.
Buddha runs a drug gang called DMM. It stands for Drugs, Money, and Murder. Let's just make it back here in one piece.
Get down, sir.
I want the narcotics and the guns. Let's tear this fucking place apart. We not late to it. What the fuck was that?
Hand him the baby. Hand him the baby. You have anything on you that may hurt me or anyone else?
Bust was a bust. No Buddha.
But who the fuck is this bitch?
Goes around, comes around now. What goes around, comes around on my side of town. My niggas trying to find a way. My attitude is always gonna be based on how people treat me. I do believe in karma and one day it's gonna get you. You gonna feel what I felt. One day you gonna experience what you did to me.
Goes around, comes around now. Goes around, comes around on my side of town. My niggas tryna find a way. Shit'll come back in the way.
So Rebecca Vargas, huh? How old are you again?
I told you, I'm 18.
So walk us through this again.
He asked me to come over, and he wasn't there when I got there.
No. What you said was, you was on your way home. You stopped by, and no one was there. All I want to know is why you were in the closet with the drugs. The only drugs in the house. With a baby. Is that his baby?
You gotta understand. You were caught in the house with a lot of cocaine, which means you could go to prison for a very long time. There'll be no one to raise your daughter, and she'll grow up in the system. Choice is yours.
I want a lawyer.
So first of all, I told him I was like, eggplant Fridays is my favorite anyway, girl.
Bitch, look at these motherfucking niggas. Man, through here. These cops are fine.
Yes, honey, but no. Most of them undercover anyway. I got one. You would know.
Three kids.
I better get you one.
You don't got three kids.
I don't even know this guy.
What's up, guys?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Let me get the fried chicken with mac and cheese and yams.
Okay. Anything to drink?
I'll get a Coke.
All right. And for you?
What you got?
The fried chicken, the mac and cheese and yams, slamming.
Okay. Let me get the same thing, but collard greens instead of the yams.
No problem. Okay.
Right, cool. Thank you.
Hey.
Y'all know each other?
Brian, right?
Of course.
Brian, right?
Where?
Yeah, and you're a cop?
Brian Bob.
Yeah.
I gotta stop using fake names.
I'ma just have these out.
Okay, you guys can have a seat.
Thanks.
And he the first ones to shit on me. He and his bitch got my house brand up in today. Now, what part of that's family? Move. I said, move.
Okay.
I cut them up.
Who are they anyway?
My neighbors.
You killed your neighbors?
Yeah, I killed the motherfucking monster. They kept playing that Spanish music all loud shit. I told them to turn it down. They will respect. They deserve that shit.
We're gonna talk when I get back.
Alright.
Kaz is fucking crazy. He's always showed signs of schizophrenia, but now he's getting older, it's getting worse. And you know niggas from the hood ain't going to no psychiatrist. No, not until something bad happens. Well, this is bad, but listen, the shit gets worse. He takes a complete advantage that I'm a cop. Not to mention shit I don't know about.
So I was diagnosed with schizophrenia at the age of 15, but I don't see it as a disability, more like a special tool. I know things other folk don't. I see what they can't, the future. I gaze into the other side. I communicate with the forces therein, my guides and protectors.
Hi!
Hey, how are you?
Tiffany?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Drugs. Closest thing on earth to God. People do anything for drugs. Steal, kill, destroy, and that's drugs on both sides. Dealing or doing. I seen kids sell it to their parents. I seen parents sell it to their kids. I seen the fairest, most beautiful women turn into scab-covered zombies. And I seen straight guys suck a dick just to feel that rush for a few seconds. Now imagine yourself a world where you don't gotta sit around waiting for some towel-headed fuck in Afghanistan to send over some dope. Imagine yourself a world where a local chemist can cook up what you need. A world where raw ingredients cost less than a tenth of what your wholesale price was on that Afghan supply. A world where U.S. Customs and Homeland Security ain't even a factor. A world where you determine the level of purity. Like the hand of fucking God. The hand that controls all the spirits, demons, and forces of nature. Now you control who has and who goes without. You control who lives. You control who dies. You are God.
Wait, I know him.
What?
I know him. That's Buddha.
Yeah, and?
I live with him.
Today is Judgment Day. Let's just make it back here in one piece.
Search for him!
You need
me! Let's tear this fucking place apart. We not gonna leave till we...
Hand him the baby. Hand him the baby.
So Rebecca Vargas, huh?
All I wanna know is why you were in the closet with the drugs.
I want a lawyer.
You working?
Yeah, and you're a cop.
You're spam!
Who are they anyway?
My neighbors.
You killed your neighbors?
Yeah, I killed the motherfucking monster. They kept playing that Spanish music all loud shit.
We gonna talk when I get back.
Alright. Hi!
Hey, how are you?
Great. Tiffany?
Yes.
Have a seat.
Goes around, comes around now. What goes around, comes around on my side of town. My niggas trying to find a way. My attitude is always gonna be based on how people treat me. I do believe in karma and one day it's gonna get you. You gonna feel what I felt. One day you gonna experience what you did to me.
Goes around, comes around now. Goes around, comes around on my side of town. My niggas trying to find a way. Shit'll come back in the way.
You ready?
Yeah.
Hi.
How are you?
Great.
Tiffany?
Yes.
Have a seat. So tell me about yourself.
Okay. I'm from Manhattan.
Manhattan?
Yeah. I'm 23 years old.
23. Mm-hmm. Good age.
Mm-hmm.
Good age.
I'm finishing up my last year of college. I want to be a physical therapist, so.
Physical therapist?
Mm-hmm.
So that means you know how to rub a nigga back.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. You said you're going to college. Mm-hmm. So,
Boss, we gotta-
Get the fuck out the way! Who the fuck is this bitch? Who the fuck is this bitch? Are you fucking deaf? Who the fuck is this?
I'm interviewing.
Interviewing for what, Kazmi? Don't be a fucking smartass.
A new bitch.
Excuse a new fucking
me,
bitch?
What kind of interview is this?
I will fucking
I'm
fuck
sorry.
You up. I will fuck you up.
You have to
fuck
keep your patience. Joe?
I'm not a fucking patient.
Can you
patient.
Please Don't remove the patient from the room?
Get the fuck off of me! I'm gonna fucking kill you in this fucking bed!
Now. Where were we? Sit down.
If you want real money, Wall Street money, you need a product that is both physically addictive and that nobody else has. That's how all the great robber barons earned their fortunes back in the day. Creating product people couldn't live without. Now, remember what I said about hiring a local chemist? Meet George. George makes fentanyl. State of the art. Not that fake ass fugazi shit they sell in the Bronx. George makes his very own custom blend of fentanyl and heroin with his trademark red dye. George is cooking up the best fucking fentanyl ever to hit the street. And yet he mixes it with heroin. The substances together provide a cleaner, better high. Then to chop it all off, the dye distinguishes George's product from everyone else's. At this point, you're already saying, who gives a fuck? That white boy ain't running no blocks. George got Buddha, and Buddha got a monopoly. Trouble is, Mount Vernon is one of the smallest cities in America. And this dude don't have the clientele to move enough to make an impact or build an empire. And if he tries setting up in Harlem, somebody gonna put a hole in his fucking forehead. I know what you're thinking. What a terrible way to run a business, killing custies and whatnot. But when one of these jackasses kicks the bucket,
The motherfucker that sold him his last bag got a line outside the door like he's giving away toys on Christmas.
What the fuck was that?
How are you?
Great.
Tiffany?
Yes.
Have a seat.
Get the fuck out the way. Who the fuck is this bitch?
George makes his very own custom blend of fentanyl and heroin. That white boy ain't running no blocks. George got Buddha. And Buddha got a monopoly. Trouble is, Mount Vernon is one of the smallest cities in America. And this dude don't have the clientele to move enough to make an impact or build an empire. And if he tries setting up in Harlem, somebody gonna put a hole in his fucking forehead.
The fuck was that?
Goes around, comes around now. What goes around, comes around on my side of town. My niggas trying to find a way. My attitude is always gonna be based on how people treat me. I do believe in karma, and one day it's gonna get you. You gonna feel what I felt. One day you gonna experience what you did to me.
Goes around, comes around now. Goes around, comes around on my side of town. My niggas tryna find a way. Shit'll come back in the way.
So Buddha's on Mount Vernon Police Department's radar. Thing is, Ari gotta keep him on the street. So we can all get on the same team. We gotta bring Buddha's shit to Harlem, package it up, and put it on the street. So we can get right back to those Nino Brown days.
This shit ain't gonna last forever. Right?
this is Officer Odell Mack, Mount Vernon Police Department Internal Affairs.
What's up, superstar? Oh, shit, man. I see you got the big boy out tonight, man. This is why I fuck with you, man. God damn, yo. Shit, you ballin' tonight, man.
Can I get in?
Hey, yo, this shit here, man, this shit is mean, man. This some other shit, yo. This is why I fuck with you, man. Let me ask you a question. Do you follow the Bible or anything like that? You go to church, you Christian? The Bible says, will a man rob God? The answer is yes. Well, you have robbed me. But you say, in what way have I robbed you? Well, in tithes, in offerings. You are cursed with a curse. For you have robbed me. You see, my brother, they don't know what I know, Detective Burns. So in your case, I am God. And my offering plate has been really dry as of lately.
You ain't no—
Shut the fuck up! Shut the fuck up! I ask for 10%. And you're right. I'm not God. I'm better than God. Cause God will let your sorry ass die 30%.
Yo, Mac, you bugging the fuck out?
What, I'm bugging the fuck out? 30%.
I bought that house. I paid that tuition. I bought your wife that fucking rock. Me, nigga. I did enough for you. Get the fuck out of my car. Get the fuck out of my car, Mac.
Okay, playboy. I'm up out your car. But let me tell you something. What's in the dark gonna come out in the light.
Shut the fuck up.
All right, playboy. Play tonight, baby. Play.
What's that? Huh?
What is this?
What is this? Who you bought this shit from? Who you bought this shit from?
Chug.
What the fuck is Joe? Yo. Yo, my man, get off the fucking phone, man. Where Jug at?
Fuck is you, man?
That's one.
Oh, fuck yeah. Yo, chill, man.
Well, yeah. Is you done or is you done? Oh, you selling my son this bullshit?
Who the fuck is your son?
Jacob.
That's your son? I had no idea. Look, the next time I see
Jacob. There you go.
Some extra. My daddy don't want you in these streets.
You can call.
I apologize, brother. You're all businessman, right?
Right.
Good. I need to talk to you anyway.
Well, what can me and you possibly have to speak about, man?
Yo, Tiger, why so hostile? You can't just have a conversation.
I'm talking now. What's up?
Now, how about we do lunch tomorrow?
Lunch?
Lunch.
Got my number.
Now how in the fuck did this shit get to Harlem? And who the fuck gave this shit to him?
What's up? I'm smoking.
Hey, bro. Yo.
What's up?
I need you to lay off bodies for me, okay? What is this?
It's that new shit. Got motherfuckers walking around looking like zombies. Or just killing people.
What's it called?
D.
D?
Yeah. All right. I'll be ready for you in a minute. I ain't gonna finish it.